Hi, I'm Oscar van Deventer, and this is the Sega DAS, the second version, and it's a success. I'm really happy to tell you that's a success, and let me immediately show you what you have here is a square that can move, and the mechanism blocks when you go out. And this has been a challenge for me for whenever I saw in the 1980s or 90s the Boomdas puzzle from Japan. The Boomdas puzzle is a sliding piece puzzle with squares that move all around. And it's really a fun puzzle to try and solve. But one of the problems with the Boomdas puzzle is it's so easy to cheat. You just take a piece off, you add it at the other side, and well, you can just assemble the numbers in the correct order as you like. So even though the Boomdas is a really good puzzle, it has a huge honor system that, because it can be cheated so easily. So when Henry Segerman and I, when we met in summer 2018, I told him about the Boomdas puzzle and about my decade-long frustration that it could be cheated. So what Henry proposed is, well, let's look at it from a computational perspective. So why should this piece come off and not come off? But for instance, number two, why can it come off? And he said, well, let's look at number five and number nine. The logic is, if there is no square here and there is no square there, then it should block, and else it should go through. So for instance, number two can move in that direction, because if here and there, then block. Ah, here there is one, so it's not blocking, so it can move. So Henry also came up with a mechanical way to implement this. So let me first show you some of the mechanisms. You see, it's a really rugged mechanism. I can move it up and down, and you can see it doesn't overshoot, it doesn't fall off. So click, here we are, and click, and you see we can play this one. Look, and I've scrambled the puzzle. By the way, the backside is scrambled too. I just added stickers there as well. But I was about to tell you about the mechanism. So each of these Sega DAS pieces, it has sensor pins. These are very hard to see, but here there are little pins that are sticking out. And when they are all the way out, they don't feel an opposite square, and when they're halfway in, they feel the one at the other side. And here is a center square as well. And the way it works, that if this one feels a square, then the other one can be pushed all the way in. However, if it doesn't feel a square, it blocks halfway. And when it blocks halfway, and the one at the other side blocks halfway as well, like this, then both of them block. But if even only one of them gives way, then you can take it apart. And of course, I can cheat, because now the puzzle thinks there's nothing here and there's nothing there. But when I push my finger on the sensor pins, come on, yeah, and we can just pull it out. But anyway, the cheating is much less easy to do, and the puzzle is much more obvious to play. Also, for putting it on, it works like that. So in order to have you see the mechanism, I'm going to show you a bit about the inside. The pins, I'm not using springs, but I'm using magnets to keep everything in place. So we have four pieces that have pins pointing up. Then we have at the other side, we have grooves that are pointing in here. And the way the mechanism works, as I mentioned, if you push a pin here halfway, then it goes into the groove, and then it enables the other pin to be pushed all the way down. And well, here's another photo that shows you the mechanism a bit in more detail. So I'm really, really happy that Henry Segerman finally solved my problem, and I've implemented his mechanism. And even though the first prototype failed, the second prototype really, it works like a charm, and I couldn't be happier. Still, there is one thing that's bugging me, that this mechanism is quite complicated. So can you come up with a simpler mechanism that achieves the same functionality, but, well, it's simpler. Thank you for watching.